tried losing my mind, but you ended up beside me every night. And I tried getting nowhere, you end up beside me when nobody is there.
Hey, it's Robinson.
Hey, Amalia.
We are, sorry, I'm really but this has hit my coordination, it's terrible. We are going to do some yoga.
Yes.
By the beach. I'm pretty uncoordinated, so I don't know how this is going to go. You've done yoga before?
Yeah, but I wouldn't necessarily say I'm coordinated either.
I feel like you're going to be better than me, but let's figure it all out.
Bye!
Bye! And talks and thinks in all the same ways that we do, but it's not me. Wrapped up yoga at Bondi Beach, which is pretty beautiful.
Look at that view, though.
It's just beautiful. So we're at Speedo Cafe.
Yeah.
Up there.
We're here.
Getting some. Is it breakfast?
Breakfast time. I don't know. It's like brunch.
Molly, question of the day. What is your go-to breakfast choice?
Anything with avocado or egg. Smashed avo on toast. Add some hollandaise sauce or.
And tomato? No tomato.
Tomato, yeah.
Yep.
Thank you.
Oh, that is good.
That looks beautiful.
Okay, quick fire questions.
Yeah.
Who is someone that you really admire?
I admire my dad a lot.
Oh, I love that.
I think he's been like a huge rock for me throughout everything. And I mean, my mom is amazing too.
Yeah.
Me and my mum are similar in a lot of ways. We're a little bit like cucaracha, which is kind of fun, you know. And it's nice to have a stable, like, person there to kind of hold you down.
Oh, definitely.
Support you, give you advice when you need it. Like, yeah, my dad's pretty amazing, and he's probably the hardest working person I know.
Oh, what is your favourite track to perform live?
Ooh. I have one still in the mix, but I've added it to the live set. It's not unreleased, obviously.
Ooh.
But that one's pretty fun just because I feel like it's fun to sing. It's challenging, but also just like it's awesome to explore that range. And it's sexy and it's like
love that.
Everything that I love.
You like
the
feel
bass,
it?
And then at the end, it's got this amazing breakdown where I just go crazy and just let loose and dance and have fun. And it's just awesome. And I think audiences are going to really like it.
Oh, I love that. Yeah. Have you always been able to like move on stage?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't consider myself a dancer, so to speak, but
neither.
I love to move, and I just think it's
feel it. Just feel it.
Yeah, a lot of it is just in the confidence and, you know, faking it till you make it, kind of.
But absolutely.
That's like a weird quirk. Just the way I move is like I just let it be.
It's your own thing.
Yeah.
Being a woman in music is like amazing, and also crazy. Like so many different challenges. What do you feel like is the biggest challenge that you've faced as a woman in music?
Something that I really admire in artists is like I look at Rihanna, I look at Taylor Swift, I look at like all these different people who are incredible business women, and I think you have to be
absolutely.
You know, it is expression, it's art, it's all of those things, but it's also a balance of looking at it like
this is a business.
Yeah, it's a business. But I think for the most part, we're coming into a day and age where there's a movement.
Oh,
towards
yeah.
women, you know.
And having an opinion and having a say and knowing what they talk about.
But it feels really cool to be a part of that movement.
Absolutely.
And it's a big theme of my music. Like, I think for everybody, I say all the sexes and all everything.
Yeah.
But I think it is kind of cool to be a woman who's strong, talking about those strong, empowering themes. And
definitely.
Owning your sexuality, owning your voice, owning, like, what you do, feeling confident in that, feeling confident to wear whatever you want, no matter what anybody says.
Exactly.
Who would be your ultimate person to collab with?
Love Jeff Buckley. Stevie Nicks.
Oh, yes.
It's just like, what about you?
I'd love to work with Drake, Ed Sheeran.
Yeah.
I just think he's an incredible songwriter.
Such a great songwriter.
And I've been a fan of his since day one.
Okay. Look, it's so beautiful.
Oh, I love it.
I love it.
So many people enjoying the ocean.
Yeah.
So what are you working on at the moment?
So I've just released my first ever EP.
Yes, I've heard it.
Which is so exciting.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That was amazing.
It's just amazing to like release it in one cohesive piece of work. Like so exciting to finally have that out. And I think the songs, it's so interesting because they are kind of like the last year and a half of my life. You know, like when you kind of go into it, you don't know what you're even going to write. now to look back and be like, oh, whoa, like that is it, you know?
Did you have a vision for where you wanted it to go when you started, or did the vision kind of happen over time? Like, what was it like for you?
I think like I'm quite in the moment when it comes to music, and I feel like I rely so much on my feelings.
Yeah.
Like that's really my approach to music. It's kind of very based on that day. And so I feel like the vision is kind of like, I've always seen it being very true to like the emotions.
Yeah, I relate a lot to that.
Yeah. And sometimes I just find when you force it,
it's not authentic.
Yeah.
You can really tell.
Yeah, right? It's just like you just have to be true to whatever feeling you feel.
Whoa, there is a bit happening. I love
that.
It.
I was waiting for that. It's on.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, just had the most beautiful day.
It was so fun.
Thank you so much for joining me. It's honestly been so incredible talking to you.
Thank you for having
about
me.
About music. Honestly, deep chats and music are like my favorite
thing. We got so deep and it was great. I needed it.
I needed that too. Well, I feel like who can relate better than a fellow artist?
It's true.
So thank you for joining me. We'll see you soon for the next episode. And yeah, bye.
Bye.